Hi friends, and welcome back to the Ara Yogi. I'm Julia, your yoga instructor for arthritis, and I'm giving myself a well-deserved hug because today is a yoga for self-love practice. I am so happy to be back with all of you to continue this yoga for arthritis journey. For today's practice, you can take it completely on your bed. It was really meant to be a bed practice, but I was not able to film on a bed for this practice. So I'm filming here in my new yoga room on the floor. So take either option that suits your body best and provides you with extra love today. What you'll need is a few pillows. So if you're on your bed, you'll have some pillows, you'll have a blanket. So you don't need anything. If you're coming down to a mat, make sure you're really supported. Bring three or four pillows, bring one or two blankets, and we'll get started on this yoga for self-love. So let's begin our practice. Find a comfortable seat, sitting up in your bed. Your legs could be crossed if that's not comfortable. You can have your legs out in front of you if you can keep a nice long spine with maybe some support underneath the knees. Just take whatever position is most comfortable. Maybe place some pillows underneath the knees. And take your hand or both hands to the heart and close your eyes. And let's start to breathe into this space. Feel the chest rise and fall with every breath, breathing deeply into the belly, the diaphragm, and the chest as we center in for today's practice. Inhale fully and exhale completely. You might notice the physical heart beating, and giving you life. We'll send gratitude and thanks to our heart. Now I want you to focus on the space right in the middle of your chest, not your physical heart, but your energetic and spiritual heart, and envision a glowing ball of bright light. Typically, we associate a bright green light with this space, but you can choose any color that speaks to you. Continue to breathe naturally in and out as you relax the body and as you relax the mind. And with your attention still on your heart space, you can repeat after me out loud or silently in your mind. I am positive. I am confident. I am graceful. I love myself. I am positive. I am confident. I am graceful. I love myself. Now notice how these affirmations are landing at the heart. Maybe you feel warmth, maybe you feel a gentle smile on the face. Maybe you feel a bit lighter. Maybe you feel the complete opposite. So simply notice, there's no judgment. This is a work in progress. And today we're going to practice some gentle self-care postures that help with releasing any stale energy from our bodies and we'll open the heart just a little bit more. So let's take a nice deep breath through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. You can sigh. You can open your eyes gently, wiggle the fingers and the toes. Maybe you can make some circles with the wrist and take your time to make your way to your back. So really take your time. You can keep your props nearby. Come down to your back, all the way down slowly. And once you come down to your back, just recognize where you need more support. Maybe it's the back of your head. Maybe you need support underneath the shoulders with a blanket. So you can place a blanket underneath the body, underneath the shoulder blades. That way you can support the shoulders a little bit more and the head. So listen to what you need in your body. Notice how it feels to be lying on the floor with the knees bent and the feet flat on the floor. And we're gonna take our time to come into knees to chest, taking one knee up at a time. Noticing how that feels in the body. And gently giving yourself a hug. You might be feeling a little stiff. You can wrap your hands around your shins or underneath your thighs for less strain on the knees. You can keep your head in line with your spine. So just listen to the sound of my voice instead of turning your neck to look at me in the video. And just breathe. And you can grab on to either the fingers. You can just gently place your hands under the thighs or grab your wrists, whatever feels comfortable for you. Maybe you're not using the arms at all because it's not comfortable. That's completely fine. Maybe you're doing one knee at a time. That's totally fine too. This is a good posture for releasing the lower back and for releasing any digestive challenges. This is called wind relieving pose because it helps, it aids in digestion, relieves any bloating in the lower belly. Breathe fully and deeply. And from here, you can turn your head to look towards the video. You can point and flex your toes gently, just for a moment. And then we'll come back to a relaxed posture with our feet and release the arms. Keep the legs where they are at 90 degrees. Release the arms in a T. You could have your palms facing up or down on your mat, whatever feels good for the shoulders. And then very slowly, we're gonna send our knees to one side. So if you need some props, you can send one foot down at a time. You can grab your pillows and your props by just rolling over to the side. You can grab one or two pillows and place it to where your legs would fall. And take your time to come back so your spine is fully supported. Slowly you can send both of the knees to the left. Maybe you're placing a pillow in between the knees as well. If it's not comfortable to keep your gaze to the side, you can bring your head back to center and breathe in this lying spinal twist. Send your breath into the belly and into the sides of the body, expanding the rib cage. Inhale and exhale in this nice spinal twist. Take one more breath on this side. Soften the shoulders down to the earth. And when you're ready, I want you to gently think about squeezing the inner thighs together. And you can place your hands back on the floor if that's more stable. And slowly send the knees back up to center at 90 degrees. Take the pillow or whatever prop you have, place it to the other side. Notice your spine is completely supported by your bed or the yoga mat. When you're ready, you can slowly send the knees to the opposite side. Maybe place a pillow in between the knees if they're sensitive. And then relax the palms facing up or down. You have the option to keep the head in line with your spine, gazing up towards the ceiling, or take it to the opposite side of the knees. This is a nice spinal twist, but it's also a nice cervical spine twist, which is the neck. So you're releasing some tension also in the neck. Release the shoulders down to the earth. Breathe. Fill the belly and the rib cage with air, with oxygen, and with self-love. And you can slowly turn your head back to center. Gently squeeze the inner thighs together. You can place the hands down on your mat if that's more stable. Squeeze the thighs together as you come back up to center. And then very, very slowly, you're going to send both of your feet down to the yoga mat. You can place your hands to either sides of your body. Now take your time and extend the right leg, maybe keeping a micro bend in the knee. Inhale to reach it up as high as you can. If you have any contraindications to leg lifts, you can omit this exercise. They might also be called leg extensions. So this affects the hip, the knee, the core, the low back. So gently squeeze the belly to spine as you exhale and lift the leg. Breathe in on the way down. Exhale, squeeze the belly and all the air out of the belly as you reach the leg up. On the next exhale, you're going to send your hands around your thigh if possible. If you need to, slowly curl the chin and the head up to grab the thigh and then slowly melt your way back down. You can place a pillow under your head if you notice that you're straining in the neck. You know, this will provide you with more support. And this is a nice hamstring stretch. If you feel tight in the back of the legs a lot, this is a really nice yoga stretch. You should feel no pain. You should just feel a stretch in the belly of the muscle. That's really the middle of the muscle, in the hamstring muscle. Maybe you feel a little bit in the calf as well. If you're feeling tight in the calf and you're flexing the toes towards you, very mindfully, I want you to tuck the chin towards the chest, lift the shoulders off the floor. Notice you're engaging the belly. You can slowly reach the arms up and just notice where they want to touch the leg. Very gently, you can touch the leg. Soften the shoulders, exhale completely. Inhale, tuck the chin in towards the chest, gaze towards the toes, and then very slowly release the head back down and bend the knee into the chest. Give yourself a little squeeze and then release that leg down. So we're doing a nice leg lift with a hold for the hamstrings. So you can inhale and extend your left leg long. Keep a micro bend in the knee to protect the knee. Inhale the leg up, flex the toes towards you. We're using the muscles of our lower abdomen and our legs, our quads. So breathe in on the way down. Exhale on the way up, squeeze the air out of the belly. Inhale and exhale. And on your next exhale, we're going to hold the leg. So you can grab onto the back of the leg without moving the head. If you need to, curl the chin in towards the chest, grab the head, and then lower the shoulders down to your yoga mat or the bed. You don't want to keep the shoulders up by the ears. You want to relax them down. Breathe in and out. Soften a little bit where you can soften. And send your breath and your love to any area of tension in the body. Send the breath there. You can close your eyes if that feels good during these holds. And then when you're ready, breathe in, tuck the chin towards the chest, and you're going to start to feel, as you lift the shoulders off the floor, the lower belly engage. You can reach your arms towards your toes and notice where you can hold on to. It could be lower, it doesn't matter. Gaze towards the toes. Breathe in. And as you breathe out, soften the shoulders away from the ears. One more breath. And then very mindfully release the head back down to the earth. Bend the knee into the chest and give yourself a little squeeze. And then slowly relax the foot back down to the floor. And place your feet shoulder width apart, your knees in line with the middle toes. We're going to come into a gentle bridge pose. Release any pillows that you might have from underneath your head. You want to have a nice supported head and spine during this posture. Your hands are beside you. Gently press through the feet. Keep the knees in line with the middle toe and squeeze the glutes. We're opening up the chest. We're opening up the shoulders. Now we're really activating the lower back and the core, but don't turn the head. Keep it looking straight towards the sky. Breathe in, keep pressing through the legs, squeeze the glutes, and then very slowly lower down vertebra by vertebra until you come back down to the yoga mat, completely supported by your yoga mat or the bed. We're going to come to all fours, so take your time to roll to one side. You can press away from the earth, taking your time to walk the hands and maybe find some support for the knees. I like using a folded blanket, maybe another fold. Taking our time to get there. Maybe we're feeling a bit stiff today, who knows? I'm feeling a little bit stiff in my spine today, so. My hands too, so I'm going to be very gentle and I'm going to send equal distribution through the hands if possible, coming into your own version of cat and cow. Maybe this isn't comfortable for the knees and you want to take this seated in cross-legged position without the arms, that's completely fine. Breathe in, gaze towards the sky, arch the back. Drop the belly and breathe in. Exhale to round from the tailbone. Gaze towards the navel and drop the head. Let's move with our breath. Inhaling as we arch the back. And exhaling as we round. Take one more like this. And maybe it'll feel good to come into a bit of a leg extension here and target the glute. So you can curl the toes under if that's available to you. If not, you can relax the toes. You can get a little toe stretch here, only if that's comfortable. Maybe wearing running shoes is more comfortable. For anyone that has foot arthritis, you can absolutely wear socks and running shoes for more support in the feet. So inhale. Round into the two hands, shoulders relax, and you can slowly press back through your right leg. A little bit of a balance here in our floor series. Keep the hips level, look down towards your bed or yoga mat, and then come back and relax the foot and the leg. Breathe in and out. Inhale the left leg back. Turn the toes down, that way you can keep those hips leveled. Lengthen through the whole body and exhale, lower. Let's do two more on both sides. If you need to stretch out the wrist for a minute, that's totally fine. Take your time. Make sure you're breathing in as you extend. And as you exhale, lower down. Take your time to feel the muscles involved. Pull belly to spine. Feel the hamstrings and the glutes. Feel your shoulders relaxed. One more on each side. And relax. You can relax the toes back down. We're going to come down to the belly. So take your time to come down to the belly if that's available to you. Keep your props close by. Let's come to the forearms for a minute, just to give the wrists a little bit of a break. You can gently roll out the wrists, keeping the head in line with the spine, gazing down, and then spread the fingers wide and keep the palms flat on your bed. Your shoulders are relaxed and the elbows are underneath the shoulders or a little bit in front to release some of that extension in the spine. Breathe in, breathe out. Open the heart, open the chest, breathe in. Breathe out. And gently bring a smile to the face. If that feels good to you, you can slowly release the head down to maybe a pillow or your hands. Take one full breath in and out. And really take your time to move. We're going to roll to our side and slowly come back to a seated position. This can be with some folded blankets or on a pillow, a meditation cushion, whatever gives you a little bit of height. So once you're settled in your seated position, think about lengthening the spine and supporting yourself with the props you need. I felt my knee a little bit sensitive in this right knee today, so give it a little bit of extra support. Place the fingertips down to the floor, whatever's available to you. Inhale and lengthen the spine. And exhale, we're gonna take a side bend to the left, bending the elbow. You don't have to lift your arm, you can just support the body, support the heart. You can lift the arm only if that feels good to you. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, press away from the earth. Send your fingertips back down to the earth. Inhale. Ground through the sit bones. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Bend to the opposite side. Slightly bending the elbow of your grounded hand. Remember, you can keep your arm down. Keep your hand to your heart. When you're ready, inhale to come back slowly to center. Close the eyes. Keep lengthening, creating space between the discs of the vertebrae. For anyone that's dealing with spinal arthritis, lengthening the spine is so important at all times and also before we take any movements, especially bends, twists. Really lengthen, create that space. Good. You can float your eyes open. We're going to send our arms up to shoulder height, if that's available to us. Send the right arm underneath the left so the elbows are stacked. Give yourself a nice hug, grabbing onto either side of your shoulders for eagle arms. This is the pose you saw me in at the very beginning of this video, and I wanted to end with this pose. It's a great upper back stretch. It's a nice hug. Sending ourselves some self-love today. The theme of this practice. Gently lift the elbows in line with the shoulders. Take one more breath. And slowly you can release the arms down. Relax the palms up or down in your lap. Take your time to come into the other side. We'll breathe the arms up, lifting them to shoulder height. Lengthen through the spine. Send the left arm underneath the right, stacking the elbows. And then gently hug the outside of either shoulder. You can gently send the elbows up to shoulder height. On your exhale, soften the shoulders down your back for this nice eagle arm stretch. And as we're in this posture, giving ourselves a well-deserved hug, think about what you can do today to give yourself more self-love. How can you think differently? How can you speak differently to yourself? How can you act differently towards yourself? And release the arms back down by your sides, placing the palms up or down in your lap. You can take a shavasana, or you can choose to stay in a seated meditation, whatever would feel better for your body right now, as we come into our final relaxation. Follow the flow of your natural breath. And send your hands to your heart, or simply leave the palms open to receive this love, this collective love that we're sharing in this practice. And repeat after me silently or in your mind. I am positive. I am confident. I am graceful. I love myself. I am positive. I am confident. I am graceful. I love myself. And now I want you to lift your chest up a little bit. Breathe in. And release all of that love into your heart. And visualize that glowing light expanding through every cell of your being, sending love to all parts of you. Notice how you feel in this present moment. Thank you so much for sharing this practice with me today. If you're interested in learning more about yoga for arthritis, you can check out my basic series. It's a free beginner's series to learn about how to practice yoga for arthritis. I'm wishing you a happy Valentine's Day and lots of self-love from my heart to yours. Namaste.